I told you those tomato plants were going to get big. I mean, they got big too. It's been a while since I've made a video, about a month, I think. This week we're going to talk about the duckweed project, what didn't go well, and what we've lived and learned. Also, the proverbial squash bug battle. We're always fighting a squash bug battle here on the homestead. The spinach has been harvested. It lived on this row. It's gone now. And we'll talk about harvesting spinach and even juicing the stalks after you get finished harvesting the spinach. You know, the stalks that are left after you pick all the leaves off. So go ahead and sit on back and watch the video and see how this garden changed over the last 30, 40 days or so. Last year's garden is just about eaten up. It looks like a lot left, but we eat quite a bit of this garden food, if you know what I'm saying. We've got everything from beef stew to just plain old-fashioned tomato sauce. Lots of dehydrated vegetables left. I even pickle eggs. Maybe I'll show you how to pickle some eggs. Dehydrate chives and thyme and basil. Lots of jellies. May not make too much jelly this year. One of my favorite is soups. Vegetable soup. Beef soup. Here's some of the leftover soybeans from last year. Great on a salad. Beans. Carrots, beets, potatoes. Hot sauce, salsa. Plenty of dehydrates. So as if it's any indication of success, then our cool weather crops are doing great. Potatoes, spinach, cabbage, carrots, and beets. But our hot weather crops are not. Our purple hull peas, green beans, okra. I mean, you can't even tell if there's any okra in that row. There's a few little small plants that are starting to do their thing, but they're just going to be replanted. I'm not going to till the row back up, but I'm definitely going to put more okra in. Of course, our lettuce is doing good, and our more cabbage I've got here is doing well as well. Luckily, our tomatoes are doing well. Corn's coming up real nice. Okay, you can see here, though, that the duckweed bed is completely covered with duckweed, or is it? There's a lot of algae. And there's something I've noticed real quick. If you'll see these white stripes, like the duckweed is dying. See that? It's almost as if the algae growth is killing the duckweed.
There goes Maybelle. She's tasting it. Maybe. It's wet. She's eating it. No, not really. I don't think chickens like duckweed.
Uh-oh, you got a moth. They're chasing a moth. There they go. They're running around with a moth. Here they come, running around with the moth. Here she comes with a moth. Maybe I won't set moth. We're here at the duckweed pond, or bed, or whatever you want to call it, and it looks like we're having some problems. We've got a lot of duckweed that has died off. We've got nice coverage, but our duckweed has died off. As far as our duckweed experiment, it didn't really turn out the way we wanted it to turn out. The algae growth suppressed the duckweed growth tremendously. At one point, we did have duckweed all over the top of this, and we removed some of it and tried to feed it to the chickens. They didn't really care for it. They didn't touch it, which, you know, it's fine, because I know other animals like it, fish like it, ducks like it, etc. But for the most part, I think that this tub caused the water to get too warm. When I was cleaning it out, it was getting very warm, almost like very hot bath water. And I don't think that's really good for the duckweed. I don't think it likes that. Thank you.
So we didn't catch any squash bugs last night, so we're going to try to see what our population's like. Make sure that we're not losing the battle before we know that we're being, you know, attacked, if you know what I'm saying. The plants all look real healthy. They look happy, but I know they're in there. And so we're going to go through and see what we can find. Now, if you'll see right there, you'll see some squash bug eggs. Not many. We could try to pick them off. We could do some other things, pinch them, but we're going to probably hurt the leaf, and we don't want to do that. So I'm going to use some duct tape. Let me show you. Now, this seems tedious, but if you go ahead and get a grip on them now, you won't have problems later. Now, this is just a small amount of the eggs that I've already picked off. I have 10 plants here, and for the most part, I only caught 6 squash bugs. So 10 plants, probably maybe 75 to 100, maybe 125 eggs, and 6 squash bugs. So that's probably why I'm not getting any in my trap. I just don't have a population. As you can see, we're harvesting spinach this morning. And I froze some last year and also canned some last year. If you want to see my videos on canning greens, just go to last year's videos, 2011 season, and you'll get the idea. It's a two-part video on canning greens. I didn't like the canned greens all that much. I wanted to make sure that I could do it. And truthfully, I believe that if you can can greens, you can can anything, because it's a 70-minute processing time. It takes a lot of preparation, washing, etc. But this year we're going to do a lot more freezing. Now, you notice my spinach is bolting, and this is a good time to go ahead and just go ahead and finish it off, polish it on in, and get ready to plant something else in the row. So some people don't like spinach when it bolts. I like it all. I like the big leaves. I like the little leaves. I'll take it all. So I'm gonna go ahead and sit here for a little bit and do some more picking, and you'll see how I do it. Now, what I do is I go ahead and have a bucket. I have two of these clear buckets, and this is where I put my fresh from the garden pickings right into this bucket. When you get a real big, bushy spinach like this, the best thing to do is to go ahead and find one that's bolted. Reach down to the bottom and clip it until you get one like this. Give it a good shake. Get the spiders and the earwigs and whatever else has been crawling on it all year off of it. And there you go, just like that. So then I go ahead and I clip right around the base of each leaf so I can go ahead and drop them straight in there. When you get down to a little twig like this, I go ahead and save this for the chickens. Now, the birds have had their fill of spinach this morning, and of course they got a big pile of greens just kind of sitting there. They'll go long, scratch, and enjoy themselves, but I ended up with a whole lot more of the stalks, and the stalks are covered in leaves, the stalks themselves, and I'm kind of interested. I wonder what it would taste like if we juiced those stalks, just, you know, when we cut them and we juice actually the core of the plant to see see what we can get out of it. I don't know what it'll taste like, but I'm gonna give it a try. Anyway, we got our harvest done here, and we're gonna go inside, and I've already done some today. I've got a few more plants to go, as you can see here, down the row. Some of those smaller ones are small, and I might even save those and use those in salads throughout the week. But I have a couple more big ones here I might go ahead and harvest. That's the downfall from the soaker. The bigger plants are near the tip, are the start of the soaker, and they get smaller as they go down line. I just don't like the soaker system, and I really would like to try it something different next time. So we're going to go ahead and wash these, and I'm going to use the water hose and transfer them into another bucket, and then we'll take them inside and blanch them. Not really. We do a lot of bugging out in the garden, so if we see one, we flip him off. And, you know, these leaves have lots of crevasses in them, so they hide up in there. So we're going to wash washed good. As you can see here, nice clean water. You can wash these things real careful, leaf by leaf, or you can just dunk them and let the bugs come to the top and splash them off. They're going to get wadded up in there. So I go ahead and just kind of take a perusal, I guess, of the bug inventory, see if I can knock as many of them as I can off. Once you get your greens cleaned and you got them inside, go ahead and get you a vat, a colander here, of ice-cold water. We're going to blanch these greens and we're going to cool them off rapidly. Once you get your greens blanched, go ahead and put them in the ice water. And so we don't want to cook these, we just want to blanch them. Just for freezing. Cool them down rapidly, and then we're going to go ahead and pack them in freezer bags. After you're finished blanching your greens, go ahead and get a little wash rag or dish towel or something to catch the liquid, because we're going to make some liquid. I've got some of these vacuum store bags from last year from Ziploc. I didn't really care for them all that much. They didn't really hold a good vacuum seal like when I was trying to seal up the sugar snaps, but they'll do just fine for greens. They'll pull all the air out and a lot of the liquid out. We don't want chunks of ice in our greens. So go ahead and get you a little wash rag, get your bags ready. Go ahead and get ready to start packing them up. So you want to get them flattened out as much as possible, because we're going to stack these. I like to double bag them too, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Now if you're using these bags, you need to make sure there are no greens over the plunger sight. Leave that part open. Just like that. Set it aside, get your next bag, and keep filling. Of course, the bad thing about greens is this is pretty much all you get out of that huge bucket that we picked from the garden just now. But it's fine. It's a good side dish. It's a good main dish if you want to do that. There's so many different recipes you can use spinach for. It's full of nutrition. We enjoy it. Now, regarding all these stems and stuff, I just didn't know what to do with it. If I can grow it, I'd like to use it. And so what I'm going to try to do is use my juicer here and juice those spinach greens, or the spinach stems rather, and see what happens. Okay, we got some juice. It's amazing how a little bit of juice comes out of things. So we're going to go ahead and pour it real quick. Nice and green, wow. Let's taste that real quick and see what it tastes like. Look, take a peek at it. It's kind of bitter, not too bad. I'll bet you if we threw a cucumber in there, it would be really good. And I might even put an apple in there for some sweetness.
This.